Ever since we first landed on the moon, people have had their eye on the next closest target for exploration, Mars. But how realistic is that? Could humans really live on Mars? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Space agencies around the globe are hard at work trying to figure out how to put humans on Mars. Maybe within our lifetime. How do they plan to do it? The journey to Mars will be long, so the spaceships can't just be bigger, they need to also be much more energy efficient. You see, once the ship leaves Earth's atmosphere, it'll need some sort of propulsion system to blast it all the way to Mars. And Mars is about 200 times farther than the moon. That's not exactly a quick trip. Even with state-of-the-art tech, experts believe the journey could take anywhere between 7 to 9 months. That's what makes fuel efficiency so important when it comes to sending a spaceship to Mars. So, for such a long trip, what kind of energy-efficient fuel might we use? Well, most likely, a super-hot, electrically-charged gas called plasma. When harnessed by a special kind of engine, plasma acts kind of like the biggest shock of static electricity you can imagine, strong enough to blast a massive spaceship into outer space. The special kind of engine is called an ion thruster. They've been used by space agencies for decades to explore deep space, but never on anything close to the scale you'd need to send a large manned ship all the way to Mars. More efficient fuel means you need less of it to make the trip. Less fuel means the astronauts have more room on board for food, water, air, research equipment, and anything else we might need while on Mars. When the spaceship finally arrives, it probably won't land. It's way too big to land safely on the surface. Instead, it'll circle around Mars, acting as a space station. Crews would likely descend in small capsules designed to land on the dusty surface. Once safely on the surface, astronauts would set up and live inside a special pressurized and temperature-controlled tent-like structure called a habitat. Why? Well, Mars's atmosphere is a lot thinner than Earth's. That means there's way less oxygen to breathe. It also means it's a lot colder. Mars is negative 81 degrees Fahrenheit on average. Not the kind of conditions humans could survive without technology. Humans would need to put together solar panels, harvest water from deep underground, and build big greenhouses full of plants that can survive all the harsh planetary conditions. Some plants would be grown for food, and others would be grown to make oxygen for the astronauts to breathe. Right now, this all might be hypothetical, but expert engineers around the Earth are getting closer and closer to bringing these colossal plans into reality, reworking and perfecting their designs for the ideal mission to Mars. So, yes, humans could one day live on Mars, but who knows when? It could be 300 years from now. It could be 30. If everything works out, it might even be you!